If you have regret about being vaccinated and boosted, I have some resources for you. I have several people in my life who have just now deeply regret that they've done this. There are quite a few solutions out there, and I'll be doing a whole series on different ones that I find and interviews with different people. I want to go with the first one that I found, though, and just to assure you that, yeah, this is a big problem. I also want to do, this is only like a short 2-minute clip or so, of public officials who were mandating vaccines in the beginning and then now are completely reversing that stance, and either they are personally apologizing or they are demanding apologies. So this is real, that the vaccine was not a good path to take. There are lots of things that you can do, though. The human body is amazing, resilient, and strong. And I will show you right after this clip the first resource that I have.
All New South Wales police employees will be required to be vaccinated for COVID-19. The latest public sector workforce subjected to mandatory vaccinations following the New South Wales state government, making it a requirement.
One mistake which was made by governments here and around the world, and that was the strict enforcement of vaccine mandates.
There's been a bit of talk over the weekend and today, as you know, about when unvaccinated people will get their freedoms.
For the unvaccinated.
No, we're not at that point. We want to obviously continue to drive the vaccination rate here in our states. But ultimately, mandates were wrong. People's personal choices shouldn't have cost them their jobs.
I talked to a lot of businesses, a lot of CEOs and kind of heads of human resources. And their big question is there any way to get workers back without mandating a vaccine? And I say, yeah, you gotta like reduce your like the number of people in there by a third or a half, make sure everybody's wearing a mask, test everybody twice a week. And they're like, for how long? And I'm like, probably for the next few years.
Crazy. Yeah.
And they just look at me and think, No. I'm like, or you can just mandate a vaccine.
In general, you don't want to use mandates unless you absolutely have to.
And to think that a third of Australians are concerned about a minimal rate of people getting blood clots is quite frankly ridiculous. And it is actually dangerous to public health. We are due an apology for these mandates that quite seriously never had any real basis in sight.
What is a reasonable level of community vaccination to achieve before we abandon mandates?
My view, not quite at the moment.
The mandates? Yes, I think we did get that wrong.
The problem is, how are they going to know who's vaccinated? You just said they showed the card. That's not the answer. The answer is a vaccine passport or any kind of systemic way that we can show it.
Not everybody needed to take it. And you made everybody take it. And you shouldn't have. That is a legitimate grievance.
When it's my turn, I will happily be injected by a traffic warden, a postman, or Tracy from behind the meat counter at Tesco's. I don't care. I want this pandemic to stop.
We will never forget the politicians, the corporations, and the high-profile celebrities and TV doctors who needlessly coerced us into having the vaccine. They've got blood on their hands.
The silver bullet against all of this nonsense we've had to go through over the last year or so is the vaccine. It didn't stop contraction. It didn't stop transmission. It was basically a measure for you to help yourself. It didn't help anyone else particularly. Why the mandates?
Publicly, I'm pretty pro mandates.
You should use mandates rarely. You should use it very narrowly.
Well, what was most important to me was seeing one individual after another embrace vaccine with confidence.
There was not appropriate transparency from the beginning about the potential side effects of these vaccines. I do think one of the greatest mistakes that was made, of course, was mandating these vaccines. They should have never been mandated. It should have been open to personal choice.
I believe that this policy was mistakenly adopted 12 months ago. The general population knows that today that the COVID vaccine doesn't stop the spread of the virus. So I want to take a moment to acknowledge that this policy caused a lot of unnecessary harm and animosity within our workforce and community. With all my heart, I extend my apologies to those who were affected negatively by this policy, and I hope that as a municipality and a community, we can move forward.
And if a pandemic comes again, we need to get a better balance, encouraging people to take action whilst at the same time protecting people's fundamental liberty.
Never forgive, never forget, and never again.
So the reason I played that clip was to assure you that, yes, absolutely, this is a problem. That those vaccines are not good medicine. It was a really bad idea to try something so untested on so many billions of people, literally. So the first resource I have for you is at the group of doctors, FLCCC. It is on the website COVID-19criticalcare.com. COVID-19criticalcare.com. I have found this to be the most clear, straightforward protocol that's out there. And again, I will be doing interviews with other people who have protocols. There's a summary here. You can click on this and get to the summary, and then you can click on this other thing and get the full protocol. The full protocol will go into, you know, contraindications or, you know, a lot more detailed studies on this, or, you know, is it applicable to you in your particular situation? And when you go into this, I'd recommend looking at the summary first. They break it down into different categories of these are the first most important, second most important, third most important. And you'll see that the list of things here, most of these are herbs or supplements that are available, you know, over the counter, online, at Amazon. There are a few that might be a little bit more challenging to get, but, you know, anything is possible, right? There's always ways to get stuff. And if you really need help, put something down in the comments and I will come up with resources for you to be able to get some of the more difficult to obtain drugs or herbs that are required for this. So anyway, I sincerely hope that you can take your health in your own hands. I believe that the human body is eminently resilient. It can overcome so many things, but you've got to acknowledge, first of all, that there is a problem and then start taking action steps toward it. And again, as I said, there's quite a few other very interesting protocols that have been developed by some interesting people, and I'm going to be doing interviews with them to feature them on what they have available. And as always, with every video I present to you, you've got to be eating high-quality food. It's getting extraordinarily difficult to be able to buy that right now. The commercial food supply is completely toxic. Growing your own food in your backyard, I can show you how to do it. Go to backyardfoodproduction.com. Even if you have no experience, you're older, or you're out of shape, I promise you, growing your own food, the process of growing your own food will bring you tremendous health benefits. And then, of course, it's delicious. So bring you lots and lots of pleasure. That's at backyardfoodproduction.com.